Hello there, everyone. I am Third Mario Brother, and welcome back to more Let's Play Sonic Heroes. In the last episode, we finished up the second to last set of stages with Team Chaotix, and in this episode, we're moving on and finishing up the final set of stages with Team Chaotix. Now, as you all probably know by this point, Team Chaotix is the last team in the game, which means, yes, we are quickly approaching the end. This is one of the last episodes. So, let's get started.
Once we start a job, we finish the job. That's the policy. We're Team Chaotix.
I'm not sure if I've said this every single time I played this level, but I really do love those poses and speeches that the teams give at the start of this level. It adds a lot of atmospheric intensity and adds a lot of, I don't know, character to the teams, and it gets you pumped up to play the stage. Anyway, our mission in this stage is to complete the level without being detected by any of the enemies for whatever reason. And this is made kind of easy if you know how to use SBO's invisibility ability. I know I said in Frog Forest that it's kind of cheap to use this ability constantly, but now that I've played through this level and now that I know kind of what it's like, there are some parts that are totally impassable without using this ability, so really I can't say that it's cheap to use it because the game designers put it there and I'm going to use it. Anyway, let's go ahead and flip this switch, go up here, we can get an extra 5 rings. And if you use your flying character here, you can fly into this hoop and, for some reason, not make it onto that ledge over there. Oh well! I wonder if that was tested properly, or if it was like a last-minute thing, like, hey, this level needs secrets, let's throw it in. Anyway, let's come and go over here. I'm not sure what these big rectangular things are, I guess they're some sort of cannon. But when you're invisible with SBO, you don't have to worry about these lasers here, which is really nice. Except I do want this 20 ring, so I'm gonna go ahead and let these things pass by, and there we go! No, don't lose. I thought I was going to lose there for a minute. Anyway, it's kind of smart to be almost always invisible because at some parts of this level, there are enemies just thrown in out of nowhere that you wouldn't expect to be there anyway. Extra 5 rings. Glad I fell down here by accident. So let's go up here and grab a checkpoint. Now, you may have noticed that there haven't been that many enemies so far, which, it will change because there are sections with a lot of enemies that we're going to have to kill while we're invisible or without getting detected, which easiest way to do that really is to be invisible. So let's go ahead and flip this switch, fly up here, turn invisible again, and could this be Eggman's armada? Oh god, Charmy. No, it couldn't be Eggman's armada. This is actually Bowser's armada. He's invading the Mushroom Kingdom with this, these ships here, and I'm gonna go ahead and use a team blast just because I have one built up. But what do they think this could be? No, it couldn't be Eggman's armada, even though Eggman's face is plastered all over every single one of the ships. I've always liked that about Eggman's character. He's such this, like, genius, powerful villain, but he's also, like, the biggest narcissist of all time, simultaneously. Makes his character quite hilarious, if I do say so myself. Let's go ahead and break open these cages. We have another little switch puzzle right here. Put our characters on each one, and there we go. Alright, and down here we have two options for flower assisting. Also, 5 rings over here. I'm not sure if there's 5 rings or another item box over on the other side, but I'm gonna go ahead and open this one up. I think this one takes you a little bit closer to where you want to be. You can use your power character here and get blow the bubble to get a little bit higher and probably be a little bit safer and get through this more easily, but I'm not gonna take any risks because I don't want to restart this, because I already have once or twice. it was kind of embarrassing, especially because I think this mission is pretty easy. Let's go ahead and run through here. Jump, homing attack, and for some reason there's that ring there that just pushes you back. For no real reason whatsoever. Anyway, there's no enemies here. Well, there's this guy. Is there one on the other side? Yep, there's this guy. But other than that, I don't think there's any enemies here, so I think we would be safe to take out Vector. Do this. Other than the cannons being here, you don't really have anything to worry about, so let's go ahead and turn back invisible with SBO so they stop firing at us, the annoying things, and flip the final switch. There's a lot of switches there for, like, literally no reason. It would kind of make navigating the battleships for, say, one of the staff members, like if a janitor had to clean up a mess on aisle 4, that would be kind of irritating to do. Anyway, we have wind here, so we don't have to worry about anything besides pressing these switches or not being able to get back up because of weird things. I'm gonna go ahead and turn invisible with Espeo because there's this laser here and I don't want to have to worry about it. Let's go ahead and press all these switches. Slowly but surely, get the job done. And there we go, it opens up that cage over there on the left side, which we can only get by using Vector. Gather up your characters in his mouth and do that, and we get a team blast, I guess. I'm not sure if we had one before, so that may or may not have been a waste, and wow, really? That's kind of mean level design right there. You didn't even know that was up there, and it kind of just flings you into it, and if you're invisible, SPO, it wouldn't have been a problem, but who's to say you are at that point? Anyway, we have this giant cannon here. Let's just go ahead and spam the homing attack on it, take it out easily, and why not? Let's use our team blast that we just got. Now for A ranks, it's very important that you kill all these, all those robots, the one that I just killed, and the yellow versions of them, because they do give you a lot of points, so just make sure to do that, and let's see what kind of rank we got. Roger.
Impossible feat! Ultimate ninja power.
And now, finally, we're moving on to stage 14, the final fortress. Find the keys to the cell where the client is locked up with the final team.
So far, so good. Here's your fucking
Yep, it's a collection mission, alright. But luckily, we only have to have five things. Well, we only have to have... yes, repeat myself when I'm trying to change the sentence up, thank you. But we only have to find five collectible items, luckily, so it's not that difficult of a feat, especially since there's more than five to find. I'm not sure of the exact amount of how many keys there are in this level, but I'm sure it's round 10, because that seems logical. It's double the amount that's required, so let's go ahead and take this guy out, because we do want an A rank. Wow. He's being stubborn. He doesn't want to get taken out. Come on. Freeze up, buddy. There we go. Go ahead and stun him with Charmy and kill him with Vector, and that's nice. But yeah, final mission is a collection mission. It kind of goes back to the roots of Team Chaotix in Seaside Hill, where we had to collect those 10 hermit crabs. So I guess his training for us, which was the collection of those 10 hermit crabs, was not in vain. Let's go ahead and fly up here. And there are a couple of shortcuts that I know of in this level, but really, you're going to have to rack up a lot of points if you want the A rank here. So don't worry so much about completing this level quickly. Worry about getting a lot of combos, collecting a lot of rings, and doing a lot of things to help your score in general. And I know that time helps your score, but not nearly as much as getting a lot of combos does, especially in this level. So we don't have to worry about being detected by the enemies anymore, so let's just go ahead and do this. Kill this dude without him even really seeing us anyway. That's cool. Anything behind these? Doesn't look like it. Oh, five rings. Not bad. Not that it really helps all that much, but... And destroying those cannons is not really worth it because you don't get a heck of a lot of points for doing it. And oftentimes, especially if you're using SBO, it can take a lot more time than it's worth. Go ahead and team blast this guy here just to save a little bit of time. And we get our second key. We could have, I think, a couple more keys at this point, but like I said, if you finish the level too quickly, you're kind of screwing yourself out of an A rank, so I'm not going to worry about it too much. Go ahead and music note blast these guys with Vector, I don't know. Let's finish him off with this move, one of my favorites. And jump in the cannon. Make sure you jump in here with Vector. I'm not sure if jumping here in here with Charmy or SBO screws you out of being able to get that switch, but... I always use Vector just in case because it worked the first time, and I can rely on it to work all the other times. Let's go ahead and jump down onto this rail. And, oh, there's a spring there. I never noticed that. I thought you could just jump off from over here, but Charmy should take lead. Yes, he should, because we have to fly up here. Let's hit this spring and come to another one of these robots. Now, what you might want to do is, while they're firing their lasers, instead of trying to stun them, which can actually make them put up their shields sometimes by accident, you might just want to kill them with your para character anyway. And if I haven't mentioned it yet, you seem to be invincible while you're attacking. So if you come to these guys and they have their machine guns out and you're kind of threatened by that, there's the key for this level, by the way, well, one of the keys. If you're kind of threatened by that, just start attacking with Vector at the right time and you should be able to avoid all damage taken. So let's go ahead and kill these guys, one hit each, very easy, and let's see what we have here. I believe it's a yellow robot, yep. Hello there, mister. Would you like to die today? That's cool. Fear my terrible music. Alright, let's go ahead and break these boxes. Under this one, there's 20 rings. I'm not sure how to get it, though. I guess you have to be very, very quick and accurate with Vector's spitting of his teammates. But this part doesn't make sense to me. This giant self-destruct switch, right? With Sonic, well, Team Sonic, Team Dark, Team Rose, it made sense when they blew up the flagships because they were just trying to destroy Eggman. They were trying to defeat as much of his armada as possible. But here, they're trying to save their client. They just blew up a huge part of this battleship, which means they could have blown up their client, and they didn't even regard the fact that, like, he was in there, and they were putting his life in danger by doing that, but, oh well, whatever. If you want an extra life, go ahead and jump onto that rail. I kind of failed doing it there. Yeah, but jump onto that rail with Charmy, go ahead and grind around, and there will be an extra life on the back of it. Pretty snazzy, if I do say so myself. Come on, fire your laser. What are you doing? What is he doing there? You're a silly neater. Anyway, take him out just for the points. But at this point, I'm not sure if it would be safe to complete the level by getting that final key there. So I'm just going to go ahead and go on a little bit further. Hopefully not too much before the next key. I don't know if I've ever been this far in the level, but I just want to make sure that I get this on my first take and don't have to redo this. Lest I get very frustrated. Anyway, let's go down here, hit that switch, and I think pole probably comes down. Yep, just as I suspected. So, what do we have up here? I'll handle it, boys. Apparently, this huge fight. Oh, maybe he was referencing those boxes, but I was gonna say, apparently this huge fight here with a single robot has to have our power character take it out. Anyway, let's go ahead and team blast and take out this heavy hammer. I believe that's what it's called. I know the guys without the helmets on are called egg hammers now. I finally looked it up. Yay! It only took me until the very, very end of the Let's Play to figure out what these enemies are called. Anyway, let's go ahead here, and whoa, flew really, really far. I wonder if there's anything off to the sides there. Probably not. It's probably a bunch of empty space, probably a time waster, so I'm not gonna bother looking. Anyway, down here, it looks like we have one of these yellow robots again. Sweet. Oh man, almost lost all my rings there. Good thing you're invincible while attacking for literally no reason. Let's go ahead and make him put his shield up so he doesn't try to fire his laser at us when we're not suspecting it. And now we can take him on mono e mono. Even though it's 3-on-1, not 1-on-1, but whatever. Go ahead and fire your laser, dude. What are you doing there? I don't understand what that motion is supposed to be. Anyway, take him out, and here's our final key.
The work of professionals!
Looks like we're in a jam, boys!
Evil must die! Beware my ninja power!
Ah! Enough of this! Just be old Charmy, Victor! Time to meet your maker!
Bring it on!
I'll show you what real evil is!
And here we go, with the final Egg Emperor fight in the game. I guess this is indeed the final stage. Whoever just said that, I can't hear your voice because my volume on my TV is very low, but I love Ezio's line there in the beginning. That was just kind of hilarious. Make sure to get as many flying power-ups as you possibly can, just as with the other teams. And I'm not entirely sure what's different about this as compared to the other teams. I'm sure there are some minute differences, but it doesn't seem that different from, like, say, Team Sonic. Either in difficulty or in design. Now, let's go ahead and try to get a team blast gathered up here, I guess. Well, I guess under that cannon there was an enemy, which there wasn't before, but anyway. Let's go ahead and gather up these rings, try to get a team blast. This is the final stage with the final boss with the final team, rather. And what you can do, instead of firing over and over with your flying character, you can just kind of rotate your control stick in circles, and your team members will fly around the center and destroy him very, very quickly.
To wrap this up!
All right! Our work is done!
Guess it was a fake after all.
What do you mean?
Dr. Eggman, I presume.
What's going on?
What's up?
You knew it was me all along, didn't you?
It's all part of being a good detective.
Were we fooled that easily?
You're rotten!
Hey, hold on, you guys. It's no trick. And besides, I plan on paying you. You'll be rewarded handsomely for helping me. As soon as I conquer the world, I will pay you!
Some nerve prophecy for James Dodd.
We've been had. Just wait a minute. Just listen to me.
Take this, you bad man!
Oh, Team Chaotix, awesome up until the end. And of course, Eggman could pay them with the millions of dollars that he kind of has to have to build all these hundreds and thousands of flagships and robots and such. But anyway, that is the end of Team Chaotix's story. I really love it. I'll be honest, playing through this was probably some of the most fun I've had with this game in a long time. If I had to pick a favorite team, it'd be a tie between Team Sonic and Team Chaotix, because Team Chaotix has a lot of fun levels and a lot of fun gimmicks to it, and I really love it, but Team Sonic is fast as well. Anyway, that is the last story of Sonic Heroes, but as you may have noticed, there are quite a few loose ends that have to be tied up, per se. There's a lot we haven't found out. What was up with those fake Eggmans? What's going on? And I guess we're gonna find out in the next part. Yes, there is more to this game than just the four teams. Not too much more, but there is a little bit more that will give us some closure and a final resolution. Anyway, as a lot of people really love Team Chaotix, a lot of people say it's one of the best themes, if not the best theme in the game. And I would have to agree, it's a really great song. I'm gonna go ahead and let the credits play, and I'm gonna leave you guys to this awesome music. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for sticking with me through all four teams. And I will see you guys next time in the finale of Let's Play Sonic Heroes.